to build our batter with 6 ounces of light brown sugar and 4 tablespoons of unsalted butter at room temperature. Cut into several pieces to make this go faster. Beat that on a medium speed until it looks kind of like wet sand. That'll probably take about 2 minutes. And then slowly work in 2 eggs beat with 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Excellent. 117.5. So stir it until it is steamed and then just let it cool down until it's about 90 degrees. While the chocolate cools, combine 1 3/4 ounces, that's about a third of a cup of all-purpose flour, with a half teaspoon of baking powder in the salt, and move it to a paper plate if you have one. Now we add the cooled chocolate, and I would do this on a relatively low speed as to splatter it around. And as soon as the chocolate's worked in, slowly add the dry goods, also beating until thoroughly combined. There. You have to stop it and scrape down the sides at least once, if not twice. Then restart the machine again on low and bring forth the chocolate. We have the 40% milk chocolate, the 70% chocolate, basically bittersweet, and the cocoa nibs, which are going to supply a seductive crunch to the final feature. Once everything is properly mixed,
look at them.
Dash your batter in the refrigerator for 45 minutes before scooping. Why? Because these cookies have a seriously out of whack weakener to strengthen.